Welcome back to Let's Play Stasis, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Are we done? Do we need surgery now? Because we have morphine now, which is great. Anticoagulant and something else. Oh, a nanite solution? Oh, so everything's off now. So that's power. Okay, do we want the robotic surgeon? Do we need the robotic surgeon? The screen of this access terminal glows with a weak gray light. And its arm is retracted just as it always was. Okay, so you go in here and then it gives you the treatment there. I thought it might be something else to do there, but... I always try to hear what that thing says. I think it's the same thing every time. So, whereas before I thought that, I mean obviously I realize it now, but I thought we'd activate the terminal, get everything ready, and then go in there. A weak gray light. Robotic surgeon by DocMate Systems. Access surgery logs. Product, P. Sowell. Operator, Dr. K. Essels. So product is a person. They're referring to people as products and not subject, but in the other room it was storage. I think they called it a product, the human being a product as well. Procedure, cranial bone extraction for Sigma Labs. So they don't view humans as humans. I wonder what the breakdown is, what makes us different from them. I like this, it says grid here, it's interesting. Notes, last surgery completed before spec op surgery lockdown. Product expired during surgery. Okay, a person died, but bone extraction was successful. Additional notes by Dr. K. Essels. The neural drill is stuck again. Every time I try to change it, the arm retracts. Please get maintenance down to fix it. Expired during surgery. Peace. This is probably going to kill me, right? Please choose surgical requirement below to extend arm and refit tool. High speed neural drill selected. Organ extraction, skin harvesting. Product spinal tagging. Now what happens if we activate? The neural drill in place is unlocked and open. Can I take the drill? Retracted. That noise at the end sounds like the, it's a sound effect from South Park. Something about people were voting for something which is most desirable. I don't know, it was weird. But you kept hearing this sound. I don't recall the episode, but I wonder if it's, a stock sound that both, the developers hear. As well as South Park access skin harvesting. So I did not take this, right? Well, I still have an empty hypodermic syringe. Good to know that we have that. So I'm thinking we're probably going to need this. Or something later. The mechanism. See if we can do something with it. But what, I don't know. Alright, what about life support? Does that affect life support throughout the station or just in this room? Like for the mechanical ventilator. I can't, I just have... There's no way to turn it off, it's just... on... and then on.
Emergency life support active.
Emergency life support. Unable to sustain life. Surgical equipment. Oh. We don't need that. Alright. Okay, I guess I'll leave this on, right? Having stuff like that on can't be a bad thing. So he walks a little faster now.
Attention. Due to the threat of external contamination, a security lockdown is in order. Please meet at your closest administration office for further instructions.
External, okay. Can I try to get in here?
Hello?
The heavy metal door stands unmoving, occasionally emitting a mechanical hum as the servos and motors attempt futilely to move it open. Futilely? See, I thought this was another room, but actually there is something here. See, that's my little... That's not part of the environment. But there is some kind of door here. Okay. Can I... Okay. Surprised I can't look at this stuff.
Is anyone there?
If there was anyone, they've definitely heard you now. Code 5449. Level lockdown. Heavy loader. Really reminding me of aliens now. With a fine layer of dust and leaking oil underneath, the loader appears to have been unused for a long time.
No power, that's not gonna work.
We actually I've been not clicking on stuff because he usually just goes over and stands, it doesn't do anything. But now he actually says something. So now I want to click on everything. Right, the information terminal reads, and I just read that. So here, will he react to this?
Security lockdown? Must be why there's nobody here. Maybe they were evacuated.
Maybe. So we got a door here, freight elevator. The locked freight elevator seems to be the only way out of this level. Okay. I can't shift run. Yeah, so annoying. So we've got two doors here. Before I even try to leave the level and go through these doors, let me see if he's going to react to anything elsewhere. And I think there might have been another way to go. I'm not completely sure. Back near the entrance where we started. Alright, so... chair. We'll see if he reacts to stuff. Maybe he's more inclined to speak now that he feels okay. Looked at the holographic projector. The terminal lies dormant, its readout blank. The screens are over here, John. Okay, John. So go back to where we were, just take a last look around. Although we might have to go back there again. Who knows? Okay, so he's not reacting to anything. Figured he wouldn't, but I like to explore all possibilities. So he doesn't have anything to say about these fans. And when I tried to move him off here, that's when it dropped me to Windows, like, alt-tabbed out. He did react to that one specimen in the test tube. Solar panels damaged in section 19B on the RM81, auxiliary electrical subsystem gauge. I just want to see if he'll react to any of this stuff. This one he reacted to. But I don't think we know that person after all. Jackson. Now they found one person in an escape pod. Now I mistakenly thought this thing was part of... This. Alright, so he didn't react at all, so. Guess we're just leaving. Nothing else around here. See, this looks like some place we might be able to go in, but nope. It was not. Oh! When I double click on an exit out, he will run. Good to know. There you go. I wonder if there's any other way to make him run. And then we'll just walk in. We just look at all this stuff. I mean, I did look at all of it. Just want to see if we react to it. Good God, the room dividers, man. Yeah, I don't think he have anything to say about this stuff. Just in case, I don't know. Oh, he'll run over to an object as well. Good to know, because we might have to run from something at some point. Or we'll run back there. Okay. Good. Because it can be boring watching this guy walk slowly around as I look at everything that I've already looked at. I don't know. Sorry, guys. What if I click on a random area? Hold on. If I, like, click here twice, he'll run. Okay, good to know. I am double-clicking everywhere now. You betcha. Alright, so this one, I'm guessing we can't get through there. Can we try?
Hello?
Urgent. Access suspended. Please see the duty officer for override permissions.
Where the hell is the duty officer?
Empty.
Jukka Cola.
Fuck, I just... Where the hell is everyone?
Yeah, really?
Doctor, where are you?
Tell me something you don't know.
My dear little girl, you don't know how happy we are to have you with us.
Oh, hi, woman. They serve a very real purpose.
He's talking about his daughter? Moments of the beast.
You and I and everybody else loaded vitamins,
what is this all about?
We asked customers what they thought about Cayne Corporation's Jukka Cola.
I love Jukka Cola.
I love Jukka Cola.
I love Jukka Cola.
I love Jukka Cola.
Oh God. Restrooms.
I love Jukka Cola.
Everybody loves a tiny first Jukka Cola. Drink one more.
Break glass in emergency. Who needs sleep? Refreshingly addictive. Jukka Cola by Cayne Corporation. Oh, that's a little scary sounding. Tree. The dead tree stands bare in the center of the room, dried leaves surrounding its base. The seats of the chairs are threadbare, the fabric pattern all but indistinguishable. Okay, that's repeating. Oh, he sits down.
Steady yourself. There has to be someone here. Someone who can help. Someone.
Are you expecting a beautiful bouncy baby boy or girl?
Breathe.
Speak to your nearest administrator for details on our month.
If you're alive, and so are they.
All expenses pay vacation to Titan. Competition is sponsored by.
So actually, I don't know how you'd arrive at that conclusion. Does he say something different for each seat? Like, will he say the first thing here again?
Baby boy or girl? Speak to your nearest administrator.
Oh, he won't say.
On our month and tots program. You could win an all expenses pay vacation to Titan. Competition is sponsored by the
C team. Flashes of information stream down the wall-mounted display. The bright red wall-mounted box reads, "In case of emergency, break glass." I mean, is that what we're gonna do? Yeah, I guess so. I guess it's an emergency. A note inside the empty emergency box reads, "Due to budget cuts, the fire axe has been replaced with this note. Have a nice day." That's just wonderful. Oh, we can take a glass shard, though. A knife-like shard sits among the pieces of shattered glass.
You don't know how happy we are.
Damn it. Myself. It's a shard.
I was about to tell him to be careful. Oh, so now we got a shard of glass and an empty hypodermic syringe. Oh, nice things to hold on to in our person. The brittle leaves from this dead tree have long since fallen to the ground. Alright. The chair is fixed in position, facing the dark monitors. I guess I can't access that. The radio is set to auto-scan, picking up various transmissions. Oh, can I turn that off? Because I find it very distracting. Guess not. The admin computer buzzes on the desk, awaiting input from a user. Hail, it is I, user! Okay, Cayne Corporation employee survey.
Yes, you over there. Ensure that you stay clean of parasites at all times.
A little tape with this kind of tape.
Exams are to be enforced.
This is electrical tape or safety. Some other kind of tape. I think it's electrical tape. It's not the black kind of electrical tape that I know about, but seen more often. Robert Freely, General Administration Officer, Security Systems. Security told us 14 days ago that they'd be rewiring the lockdown systems. So for 2 weeks we've had to deal with random system shutdowns. 2 days ago, Peters was locked in the bathroom while it flooded, and we only got him out this morning. I'm just thankful this didn't happen last Tuesday when hydroponics had to screw up with the poison mushrooms, or I would have been painting the walls of the elevators in transit to the crew-level bathrooms. What? Maintenance was down here for the final... We don't have dates or anything here. Maintenance was down here for the final rewiring of the lockdown systems. It's all working, except they cross wires with the central product storage systems. Every single time a leak is reported in the storage tanks, the system resets instead of auto-sealing the leak. It's nothing we can't deal with in the short term. I know it's going to take forever to get them back down here to fix this. New doctor complaint. The new doctor in charge of cracking pods has complained about the surgical bot. Something about the tool selection. I told him just to log a complaint with maintenance like the rest of us and hope something happens. He was not impressed. Yes, that surgical arm in the emergency room, quote-unquote, that we were in. The clinic or whatever. New personnel request. I spoke to Sarah Salvatore, a nurse in product storage, about getting in some new personnel to help with the opening of new stasis pods. The last nurse left due to the emotional stress. I guess she had a breakdown when they cracked the pod and there was a kid inside. Hope it wasn't this kid. Does this say good? Fair? Good? Excellent? I wish I could read what it says. I wonder if on a, like I'm playing this on 1080p resolution, I wonder if I was playing this, like, on a lower resolution, if I could read that. I wish I would shut up. Notifications to all general crew members. Lockdowns. Just a note to remind all crew that the lockdown system is still connected to the storage tanks. If the system locks down, you can falsify a leak and it will reset. Robert Freely, General Administration Officer. Bathrooms. The bathrooms are now in working order. Peters will be back on duty in 4-ship rotations. Robert Freely, General Administration Officer. Okay, product storage security. Oh, so I can open up that other door, maybe? Administration office door unlocked. Infirmary unlocked. Maintenance door locked.
Notice. Maintenance doors unlocked. Lock will be engaged in 3 hours.
Okay. Product storage bay 1. Product storage bay 2. Door is damaged. Please call maintenance. Main freight elevator locked. Can't even get there. Alright. So I'm going to head there. Soon. Let's check out the bathrooms. Bound to be very pleasant. I aim to keep this bathroom clean. Your aim will help. Metal sink. A standard metal sink caked in soap and dirt. Water stains streak down the metal sink. A metal sink stained by the drip, drip, drip of blood. And a clean metal sink. Let's use the clean one. What if we use the blood? Doesn't matter. Okay. A filthy wet towel plugs the hole of the toilet. Do I want this towel?
This is disgusting.
Yet somehow I picked it up and now I'm keeping it on my person. There's truly something wrong with me. A surprisingly clean toilet bowl.
Good to know the important stuff keeps on working.
As always in adventure games, you keep everything that isn't locked down. And if you have a screwdriver or a crowbar, some things that are... you can pry them open and then take them. Flushing won't clean this metal toilet bowl of the rust that has accumulated over the years. Alright. Just going around flushing toilet bowls, because that's how I roll. Maybe there's an achievement for activating all 4 metal sinks. This one's in soap and dirt. I didn't try that one. Okay, nothing horrifying coming out of it. Okay. Just want to make sure there's nothing else here. Alright. Run out of the bathroom. Okay. Is there another room off of here? No. For some reason. I guess I always think there's something there, because I see this, but that's our inventory. But that sounded really scary for a second. Well, there's that door. But I want to check back here, actually. Oh, I figured this would be open. Has it been 3 hours already? Oh, this is the one that says contact maintenance. Alright, so we've opened that. The other door is the one it was. Never mind. I was where I was supposed to be. Alright, let's go here. Am I just running too much?
Warning. Air filtration system offline. Toxicity increasing to dangerous level.
Okay, so we mess with these things? Pressure regulation? Pressure release valve. The large red reel might have a chance of turning if you give it your all.
It's stuck.
So if I give it my all, though.
Come on, old man.
We're gonna have a heart attack after all.
Ah, there you go.
Cool. Normally I would give up after one try, but he had a different response every time. So I guess air is being regulated now. Or air pressure, rather. Or both. System failure.
Oh.
What?
The smell. It's sweet.
We found the cotton candy machine. I want cotton candy. Ooh, got a PDA. System failure screen. Let's look at these first. The monitoring screen reads system failure. Please contact A. Brian, engineer level 1. Brian Adams? Same. Let's say fluid tanks. The sound of bubbling liquid resonates inside the huge fluid storage tanks. So what kind of fluid is in here and why has it failed? The empty barcoded crates have been stacked untidily against the wall. We can't open them. Can I scratch them open with the shard of glass? I doubt it. Checking out the PDA then. Oh, yeah. Andrew Bryan, engineer level 1. October 5th. Don't have a year, though. Free Jukka for every 20 punches. Only valid at the titty twister? Terms and conditions apply. Read the back. 20 punches. So the black ones are unpunched? Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's actually showing us the background of what it's in front of. I don't know where I was going with that. So that's interesting. All right. So we've got this Nuka Jukka Cola thing going on. Interesting. Adding soda to a world makes it real, right? October 5th. Andrew here. It's about 6 a.m. I'm absolutely exhausted. Really? That's all I have to say for the entire day. October 16th, Simmons volunteered to be a research subject, ... October 18th, CSEC sent me down to the ass end of the ship to fix the fluid storage vats. Okay, can we read more about this? Wait. Does this go on more? Oh, it does. So this is the most advanced scientific research ship in existence, huh? Bullshit. I've been here for only 3 months, and now I know why the previous guy quit. Leisure equipment, steam vents, circuit breakers, everything has at least one serious design flaw. Not only are the coolant systems capable of failing, everything's capable of failing, they're capable of at least 4 different types of fault, and I can only spot 2 of them in advance. Oh, hold on a second. Itchy eye. The ship's been running for 50 years, and nobody bothered to do any upgrades. Bottom line, the casings are shoddy, and they're going to need months of work to make them 100% safe. I've also pulled a muscle in my shoulder trying to rotate the pressure release valve. The bastard needs to be turned 3 goddamn times. I can see that. Next. Okay, it goes to the next that we've already seen part of it. Simmons volunteered to be a research subject, and something has been off with him since he got back from the labs. I don't want to report him to security, but I'll keep an eye on him. Bleeping research departments, can't they use monkeys like everyone else? Zero zero one. Something scan breakdown. Can't they use monkeys like everyone else? CSEC. It reminds me of Mass Effect. CSEC sent me down to the ass end of the ship to fix the fluid storage vats. Again. Not too long ago, other vats malfunctioned and started spraying that acidic shit all over the place. The bulkheads locked down and the entire maintenance crew dissolved. Oh my god. They only found teeth. Holy crap. I'm not going home in a jar, so I've killed the security system lockdown. If that thing so much as pisses that ass in my direction, the system will reset all the security procedures. Safety first. Yeah, no kidding. You don't want the only thing left of you to be... teeth.